the building. Can we crank up Resurrection Sunday with a good round of applause for Jesus?
Let's go.
Can we make some noise? Good morning, everybody. This
good
is
morning.
Good Morning Living Faith, your pre-service show extravaganza experience.
We can say egg extravaganza.
Moment.
It's because we have the Easter egg.
So yeah, for sure. Egg extravaganza. Listen, this is your Sunday morning worship experience here at Living Faith Tabernacle. This is Pastor Mark, and this is my amazing, wonderful,
keep going,
blue-hatted,
come on, this my mama hat. This my mama hat.
Great co-host,
Tamara Lewis Johnson, in my mama hat.
Yeah, I said that's nice. That's a good one.
You
too.
See, she.
I see that.
Yeah, I normally would say casket sharp, but I don't want to be there, so I'm going to just say I'm cleaning in the board of health.
No, that's
fair. I'm cleaning in the board of health.
That's for it. That's
hallelujah.
And we are located right here at 5880 Old Dixie Road.
Forest Park, Georgia, 30297.
Yes, and we are the church that does what, family?
Makes you fall in love with church.
All over again.
They better preach.
Listen, they're doing their good preaching already. And as you see, well, you probably can't see the crowd yet, but it is old school throwback 90s Resurrection Sunday. If y'all could see the hats in this room.
You'll see them in a minute when they pan over.
You see, look at this. You see. Oh, yeah, you.
I think she got a Beyonce edition.
It's definitely, it's giving mother's board.
She's
definitely giving mother's board.
She need to have on white gloves.
That's it.
She need to have
we modeling hats?
Oh, wait a minute.
We modeling hats?
It's the shoes, though.
It's the
hat.
Okay. All right. Okay.
Not couture.
Listen, coming straight from our Mother Myrtle collection.
Yeah. Missionary.
Got okay. District.
District.
Coming from our district missionary.
She run the whole situation.
No, she came together. No, there's approximately 2,047 sparkles on that. I counted 2,047 on that hat.
Well, you missed the side tassels, though.
I seen them.
You counted that in your head count?
Do we have anybody that want to show off their hat?
Come on here.
Mama Pam, come show your hat off.
First of all, if she fall, I know something.
Come on here, come show your hat off. There we go. We got a hat modeling situation going on.
Go.
All right, here we go, Mother Annie. All right. There we go. Y'all
it's
see
purple. It?
But wait
it's
a minute.
Giving.
No, let me tell y'all what y'all missing. Y'all not missing the fact that she from the top to the bottom.
Yeah, she purple down.
It's all purple right now.
What did Biggie say, Gucci down to the socks?
This is resurrection royalty right here. Okay. Mama Pam, let me help you.
Help her up because I swear she can't say no help.
Can we just clap? Do y'all see what is going on this Sunday morning? Wait a minute. Not this fan.
It's the fan.
Not this.
I don't know if we're going to look at the fan or the white stockings. I don't know what I'm focused on.
It's a lot. Yeah. It's a lot to be discussed.
Yeah.
I see.
Where's these men at to get this lady
down
before
her,
she
catches?
Her. Okay.
No, we good.
Stopped,
I got her.
She said her men ain't got no feet.
Listen, y'all see this?
You know it.
But I didn't see the sparkles on the buttons. On the fan?
You see her.
Nah, she put it together.
You see her.
She put it together.
That's somebody grandmama.
That's your mama, ain't it?
Technically.
Okay.
Yeah. I came
trying to figure out who mama that is.
This one of her hat.
Y'all, it's going down. Will there be one more? I hate to call you out.
Come on, Vanessa. No. Vanessa, come on up here. This joker came. I took a picture of her.
Vanessa about to go ahead and put
Vanessa, come on over here.
Come on up here. She got the gloves.
Wait
a minute.
Go grab this woman before she trips.
I'm about to go get her.
Let me move out the way.
Look, y'all see the gloves? Do you see? Listen.
Wait a minute.
Come on
Turn
here.
Turn around.
Listen.
We said come Easter.
Coming
Easter.
From our third Sunday of a Sunday school collection. That's Sunday school for third Sunday right
Baby.
There. Yep.
You better bring it.
There you go, straight out of it. I love it. And look at this hat.
No, it's the Spiegel catalog. Who has Spiegel back in the day?
Spiegel. That's it.
That's out the Spiegel catalog
is it.
Montgomery Ward.
Listen, y'all, I'm telling y'all, there's so many, it's so much beautifulness.
Everybody looks
it's
amazing.
There's so much beautifulness going on.
Is that a word?
Yeah, it is a word.
Okay.
It's so much beautifulness going on here at Resurrection Sunday. And though we look beautiful, and though we look nice, can we
what
just...
What the heart look like?
What
if their heart don't look no good,
where I was, I was not going
there
with
you. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought we was preaching.
No, I was saying that we're here really to celebrate our risen Savior.
Hallelujah.
And our risen... Can we clap for
Hallelujah.
Jesus just getting up?
Hallelujah.
Come on. I said for Jesus,
he
y'all. Come on.
Up.
Listen, he got up, man, with all power in his hand, and that's why we are here. And I know that today's service... is going to be phenomenal.
Awesome. We are at 5880 Old Dixie Road.
Yes, Forest Park, Georgia, 30297.
And we start promptly at 10. Y'all got to get
y'all
here.
Y'all got time to get here. And listen, if you are at home, this is what I want you to do. I want you to still put your hat on.
And take the bonnet off.
Take the bonnet off. Put your hat on.
So your bonnet is not a replacement hat.
Wait, do what?
The bonnet is not
your
a
bonnet
is not a replacement hat.
It's not a replacement hat.
Yeah, you don't wear it. Like this.
Okay, all right, I got it. So
I'm teaching.
I teach better than what we saying.
Yeah, responding.
Amen, yeah. So again, y'all, it is Resurrection Sunday. So if you're at home, we need you to like. We need you to share.
Share.
We need you to comment. We need you to subscribe.
And you need to come to church. How about
and
that?
And if you're in Atlanta, I need you in church. Now, if you're out in North Dakota, you know, first off, welcome to service.
Welcome.
I know it's early out there.
We welcome you.
But make sure you put your hat on. And I want you to do this. Take a picture.
Oh, that's good.
Tag the church.
What's the church? At Living Faith.
At Living Faith Tabernacle. And I want you to hashtag LFT Resurrection.
That's too many words.
24.
That's a lot.
Huh?
Just.
LFT Easter 24. Do that. LFT Easter 24. Hashtag.
I don't think she wanted the 24 added on there.
No. Okay, LFT Easter. Just hashtag LFT Easter. Tag the church. We want to see your good stuff at home.
Amen.
We want to see you put your good stuff on. Put it on and go to the couch.
And
cook
watch.
And cook your breakfast of choice.
And bring me some.
But if they in North Dakota, they can't bring you none.
Airlifted. I'm hungry.
Church definitely going to be over by the time it get here. But no, so this service lineup, guys, we
it's
have...
amazing.
We get to see a little bit of everybody today, guys.
The babies.
The babies
Who
are going to be out there.
Who has Easter Sunday without the children?
Hey, let's practice on 1, 2, 3. We're going to say all, okay?
Ready?
1, 2, 3. That was about a 7. That was about a 7.
You want a 10.
I need a little bit more juice, okay?
Put
all right, here
some,
we go.
Put some. They're coming.
Put it all here, okay?
Ready?
So just wait. So we're going to do the all, and then I need one brave volunteer at the end of the all. You need to say, take your time, baby, okay?
Oh, yeah, that's definitely 90.
All right?
That's definitely 90.
That's 90s. Or it's
yeah.
our,
old school.
Okay? That's it, okay?
School.
All right, here
I'm
we
ready.
Go.
I'm ready.
We're going to the all, and I need one brave volunteer. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Thank y'all. Thank y'all so much. Because it's going to happen today. We need it. Listen, we get the babies. We have the choir. And they filled this thing on up, too.
They did.
I heard they're doing their good singing.
They got the people in the front of the microphones that know how to carry it, too.
Don't.
The other ones. Right. If you see somebody in the back, just know.
Don't, no.
They might not be able to carry that.
They can.
Okay.
But
listen, the choir,
they're here, and it's going to be amazing. Our
praise
dance,
and worship.
Praise and worship, obviously, going to be crazy.
Off the chain.
And then our dance team.
Don't start, because I already know. I start getting emotional.
I already got tissue by
I
my seat.
I get emotional about...
About the dance.
Worship with Wonders? Worship... Worshipers
Warriors of Christ.
Oh, Warriors.
The Warriors of Christ.
They changed the name this in 2024. I got to get used to it.
I get it. But no,
but
I'm sure they're going
to... the same OGs.
It's going to be amazing.
They're same OGs.
So we said we got praise and worship.
Praise and worship.
We got the babies.
Of course.
We got the children.
Oh,
choir.
We got the little choir. What's the name? Lily gave me a name.
The babies choir?
She named them.
She gave them a name?
And I don't know what it is, but it was like Little Faith.
Raise the Sunshine? I don't...
We'll talk about it.
Do we have a name for the... Okay, but the babies.
We need you.
Okay, wait a minute. One, two, three, all. 1, 2, 3. Thank y'all. That's how you got to bounce back.
We need you to log on and tag what we should name the choir, because we don't know what to name the choir for the babies. So let's get interactive.
Let's get interactive.
Go ahead and tag what you think we should name the little... We don't want to call them the junior choir, but I'm going to say that for now because we're old school right now.
So, does the mass choir, do they have a name? Is it
we're not
LFT Mass Choir?
We don't care about the old people. We talking about the babies.
Why? But why? Okay. But no. And then I'm sure, obviously, the word is gonna be.
I was given one assignment: name the baby.
What assignment? So, okay, so we got the babies, we got the choir, we got the dance team, and yes. Obviously the word is going to be...
The word is going to be off the chain.
Amazing.
Pastor Jeremy Tuck is in the house.
I'm sure here.
Can y'all give a round of applause for your pastor?
For our pastor. Come on, y'all. Come on. I'm wondering what he wearing.
I don't even know. But
I wonder if he coming in with a big robe. I don't know. If he coming with just a suit.
We don't know. We don't know.
It's no telling.
It's no telling. Y'all need to tell me if he going to have
one. Does anybody know how big the robe?
Has anybody seen Pastor Tuck?
Has anybody seen? No.
No?
No, we got no takers. Okay, I don't know.
We don't know what he got on.
Because I know back in the 90s, the robes would be like real big.
They had those robes. Then he had that little, you know.
Does anybody know the name of those robes? Or they just call robes? Do we know?
It's called something.
Is it called? Do y'all know what it's called? Anybody in the audience here know what it's called?
We don't have no veteran saints. We got seasoned saints.
I feel it.
They never showed up at the board meetings.
So I don't know, but I'm excited. I'm excited to see what's going on. I'm excited to see hear the word, man. It's gonna be great.
So right after church today, we have the
right after church. What's happening?
After church.
What's happening?
We're having our Easter.
Our Easter extravaganza for the babies on the count of three. One, two, three. All one, two, three. Y'all all sleep. Right. Y'all done slept on me. One, two, three.
Good
Thank
job.
Y'all. Listen, so we're going to be celebrating with the babies right outside, man. It's going to be a great time. We got
with
a live DJ.
Socks. Oh, we have a DJ.
We have a DJ. We're going to have the eggs with all
we
of
have
the
games.
We got games.
It's some money in them eggs. When y'all win, please think of me.
Listen, all I know is it's going to be a great time. It's yes. going to be a whole lot of eggs, a whole lot of kids.
A whole lot of children.
So I need you to come. Bring the babies.
Bring the babies.
Out. It's a
we
safe place.
We are assigned to our church.
And our church is what?
Assigned to the community.
Absolutely.
Come on out. Join us for the Easter Egg Extravaganza every Wednesday at 7. What do we have?
Every Wednesday at 7 right here at Living Faith Tabernacle is Bible study. Can we clap it up for Bible study? Come on, y'all.
Who is really getting the word?
Can we listen, man? It has been great. We have been in our sermon series this whole month on
Get Up. It was Get Up.
And so I know he's going to be wrapping it up today, which, I mean, this is the perfect.
This is the last day.
This is the perfect Sunday to wrap up Get Up, because that's
get
what
up.
He did.
Because he got up.
He got.
Hallelujah.
I had to do that. No, he Hallelujah. Got up, man. And so I'm sure he's going to be wrapping that series up today. But this upcoming Wednesday, we'll begin our new series.
And we don't know what it is.
I'm excited.
I've been asking for the name, and it's
I'm excited. So this Wednesday, we need you right here at LFT to get the word of God. And then on Saturday.
5 a.m.
Saturday, early Saturday morning.
Ooh.
See, I said morning.
You see that?
Early.
One song.
Saturday morning. Oh, I say Saturday morning.
That was a different song.
We have 5 a.m. prayer right Woo! Here at LFT. Woo! Yo, do y'all love 5 a.m. prayer here at LFT? I said, do y'all love 5 a.m. prayer here at Living Faith? Listen, man, it's going to be great right here, 5 a.m. in the morning. Now, I know you're wondering, so what time does 5 a.m. prayer start?
Does anyone know?
Thank you. Okay, be so lit. Listen, so we need you here. It starts at 5. It does not start at 5:05. It does not start at 5:10. 5 a.m., we are ushering in the presence of the Lord. And we need you right
here. You might
want
to come earlier because they start saturating the parking lot like 4:30.
Yeah, for sure. So we need to make sure that you are here. Come, man. It's great. Let me say this. If you've never been to 5 a.m. prayer,
shame
I think
on you.
You need to experience. When you get up early, what the word talks about early, will I seekly? It's different. It is something, man. So we come together. We seek God's face together. We need you in the building on April 6th at 5 a.m.
Okay. He's telling the truth.
What's going on? Tell us what's next.
Ordination service.
Ordination service.
So
on,
that's when, like, the
so we got new elders. We got new ministers.
Uh-huh.
New elders.
Okay.
And we have some executive pastors being ordained.
What?
Yes, all on that day.
What?
So what is that day?
It's April 14th.
April 14th. Can
oh
we,
my
first
goodness.
Off, can we thank God for the new leadership that is coming into this house? All of the ministers. All of the elders, the executive pastors, it's going to be an amazing time, man. Make sure you tell a friend.
Check y'all out.
Tell a friend.
Bring a friend. Bring a family member.
Listen, tell a friend. Bring a friend. Bring a friend. Tell a friend.
And bring them.
And bring them. Yeah. All of that,
you
guys.
You get to come to church.
I mean, it's amazing because you get to see, again, the new lifeblood come into the church, and you guys get to see people going to be doing different things around the church.
Decent and in order.
Decent and in order.
That's old school.
Yeah, it is. It's going to be great. So Hallelujah. That's going to be on April the 14th.
April the 14th, probably right. At 10.
10 o'clock, our 10 o'clock service,
Beat
I believe it's going to be right.
I thought
you said, be ye there.
No, I was, that's.
That's what you heard too?
That's good. That's old school Bible.
Did you just invite them in King James? No, you just invited people in King James. I've never heard.
If that's what you heard, I'm going to let you roll with it.
Okay, guys. April 14th, be ye there. Be ye in the presence.
And we need you on the 20th. This is not for any one particular ministry. This is for all y'all sitting here with your hats on.
Everybody.
I need you to put on that baseball cap.
Everybody.
Your sweatpants.
Everybody.
A t-shirt.
Everybody.
Them sneakers.
Everybody.
I need you to get ready to hit the ground running because we're cleaning up this church on the 20th.
What's the date?
On the 20th.
April 12th.
It say 12 and 2. It's 12 until we get finished. This is like a 16,000 square foot.
Listen, building. This is the thing. We're doing a spring cleaning for the church.
Hallelujah.
Okay? And so if you want to be a part of that, if you want to help, we need
you
to.
No, we don't care if you want to be a part of it. We're telling you to show up.
We need you to show up.
Yeah,
okay?
we need you to show up. Sometimes you just got to be direct.
I need you to register and text the word clean.
C-L-E-A-N. Because some of y'all might not know how to spell it.
C-L-E-A-N.
I shouldn't say that. Once again,
I said spell the word.
Out of order.
Text the word clean.
Text clean.
To 404-361-0812.
And then show up to clean.
Absolutely.
Cleaning is not what you do.
I'm gonna let you get the next one for the ladies.
I want to tell them about the cleaning part again.
Okay, tell them about the cleaning.
If
and they
cleaning
go to the...
is not what you do, it's okay. We're gonna show you how to do it the right way. We're gonna teach you because some of y'all might not. Am I out of order?
I didn't say a word.
Some of y'all might not know how to do it, so we're gonna teach you. So we're bringing back old school traditionals.
Teach me how to clean.
Teach me how to clean.
Sorry, it's resurrection. Everybody clean.
Because we might need to teach you a thing or two. It might help you in your social life.
Listen,
Might go ahead and get you a. Am I part of the marriage ministry?
There was an old man of God. He used to say this. He used to say, clean up, everybody, everywhere. Oh, that was Barney? I thought that was. I thought that was somebody's sermon. It was clean up.
So
everybody.
Everywhere.
Everywhere. Clean up.
Everybody.
Everybody. Do what?
Do your share.
That's the text.
That's still old school.
That's the text for the 20th. Okay. That's the.
Yeah. So
yeah. That's
clean.
That's first Barney chapter 3. I need to make sure y'all.
First Barney chapter 3:2-1.
It's clean up. Say it with me. Everybody. Clean up. Everybody do what? Thank y'all for that.
I think they got it.
April the 20th. Okay, then the next one. Tell us about the next one.
Let me tell you about what's going on.
The 27th.
I feel like something is missing.
The 27th.
Okay, it's not. The 27th.
Yes.
The women's ministry is having the spring brunch.
Ladies.
This is not just for the single ladies. This is for all the ladies. Yes. All the ladies. I did go ahead and register by typing what? Brunch?
Brunch.
Type brunch to 404-361-0812.
Right.
We know that there is something going on with the glitch. It'll be fixed today or Monday.
Okay.
So
okay.
It's when you register, go ahead and type the word brunch. If you go in, it's $15 per person, ladies.
But you still want to make sure it's on your calendar.
Don't let
the registration glitch. Throw it off your calendar.
Correct.
Make sure it is
go ahead
on
and put
your
it.
Calendar.
The only thing is when we get to the door, we're going to ask you for the rest of the money. That's all. Can I say that?
Yes, you can.
So if you register today and you put three people, you owe $45.
Carry the five.
And if you pay $15, you know at the door... You owe us 30. And we know who you are. Whose mother is that?
Again, that's your mama.
Clearly, it's in the bloodline.
That's it.
It's in the bloodline.
So that is it. When you want to text the word brunch.
Brunch.
To 404-361-0812. And I got to give them this last one.
Okay, go ahead.
Can we shout out our amazing seniors ministry? Woo! Come on, y'all. Listen, they are doing their flowers affair. They say, give me my flowers
while I can
still smell them. They say, give me my flowers.
Who's it?
I thought I had an organ right there. Okay.
I know.
There's somebody.
he ain't on the clock.
Give
yet.
Me my flowers. He ain't
tell
on the clock
him yet. Don't do
it's
you.
Okay. It's all right.
Don't
you're
do
right.
You. You
you're
ain't
right.
On the
that's
clock.
On me. That's on me. Give yeah. me my don't flowers while I can still smell them. Listen, that is for our seniors ministry. 62 and older. They are doing their event.
Wait a minute. She said 62 and older. However, because none of these ladies that I've seen so far look 62 and older.
Correct.
They letting them in.
Correct.
They letting them in.
Well, listen, we got to get to church, but if you want to do that, we want to text the word flowers.
Yes.
FLOWERES to that same
number. It is our time,
number.
Y'all.
It is time for church.
We have to go saturate the sanctuary
absolutely.
In prayer.
Thank y'all for
we
hanging with us.
Love you.
Absolutely. Well, listen, this is Pastor Mark, and this is
Tamara Lewis Johnson.
And we want to say
good morning, living faith.
See y'all next week.
Let's enter into his presence this morning. Let's give this little time to be able to just invite the presence of the Holy Ghost. Father God, we just thank you and we praise you, Lord God. Lord, we thank you for sending your son Jesus to die on the cross for our sins, for our healing, for our restoration. Lord, we thank you for the sacrifice. We thank you for that sacrifice, Lord God. Father, we glorify your name. We honor you. We praise you. Lord, there is none like our God. There is none like our God. Father, we just glorify your name, Father. Holy Spirit, we ask you to come and rest upon your people. Fill your temple with your presence, with your glory. We invite you to come in. We yield to you on today, Lord God. We yield ourselves, Father, our mind, our will, our emotions. We yield to you. We ask you to come and saturate the ground. Let your anointing come through this place and rest upon everyone here. We thank you for the word that will come forth today. We thank you that it will break chains, the chains of bondages off your people. We thank you that the word will make us new in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for Pastor that he will be open to the Holy Spirit, that he will be moved by your spirit, and that he will be yielded. We thank you for the music ministry, Lord God. We thank you for the voices. We thank you for your anointing upon them. We thank you that as they sing, that lives will be changed, that they will usher in the presence of your Holy Spirit. We thank you, Father. If anyone be here, Lord God, heavy burden, Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, that they will come to know you, to just lay it down on the altar. That they will leave changed. Let not one of us leave here the way that we came. Father, we just thank you and we praise you. We just thank you and we praise you. Because there's none like our God. There's none like our God. We worship you, O God, and we glorify your name. We glorify your name, oh God. We thank you for your presence, oh Lord. We thank you for healing that's going to take place today, Lord God. We thank you that depression has no place here, Father. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord God, that salvation will take place today, Lord God. Speak to the hearts of the people that are coming, Lord God. Move upon them, Lord. Put them in a place where they would learn to accept you as their Lord and Savior, that they would yield themselves to you, Lord God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. Father, we just thank you. We just thank you, Lord. Father, if you never do anything else, we say thank you. Thank you for saving us, Lord God. Thank you for dying on the cross, Jesus. Thank you for taking the stripes on your back for our healing. Thank you for yielding. Thank you for saying yes and yielding to the will of the Father. We say thank you. Thank you for getting up on the third day. We thank you. We thank you. We say thank you, Lord. We praise you, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We say thank you. We say thank you. Hallelujah. Stir us up, oh God. Stir up the gift in us, oh Lord. Hallelujah. Stir it up, oh God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Bless the name of the Lord. 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 Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. What day is it today? What day is it today? Today is Resurrection Sunday. Today is Resurrection Sunday. It's because he got up. We can get up. Hallelujah. Today is the day we admonish the blood. Oh my Dios. Today we think about the blood. Today we think about the nails that went in his hands. Today we think about the nails that were in his feet. Today we realize we can get up because he got up. Hallelujah, Jesus. I was on my way to church this morning and I asked the Lord, what am I going to say to the people of God? And he said, I don't want them to think about their problems. I don't want them to think about their issues. I don't want them to think about their checkbook.
For the blood, she said, because the blood is covering us. Yeah. We say hallelujah. Thank you for the blood. Glory. Thank you for the blood. Hallelujah. 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 Forgive me if we act undignified today, but it's resurrection. Your neighbor, just tell them I'm glad that I'm saved. Oh yeah, I could have been out in the streets, but I'm glad that I'm saved. I've been washed and bought with a price. Hallelujah. Are y'all ready to celebrate our risen Savior? Come on, the tomb is empty. Yeah, the tomb is empty. We came to celebrate because the grave is empty. Oh, glory! Hallelujah! Glory! Come on, clap your hands one more time. Y'all, this is our throwback Sunday, and we want to have church like how we used to have it. Hallelujah! So can we throw back and sing some of the songs that we used to sing for Easter? And if I sing them, y'all gonna sing them with me? Shout hallelujah! Come on, let's do it. Put your hands together. Oh, bless your mighty name, Jesus. Yes, Lord. I don't see y'all clapping. This is my favorite time of the year. Hallelujah. It reminds us that our God is still real. Hallelujah. I believe in the death. I believe in the burial. And I believe in the resurrection. Hallelujah. Anybody still believe in the resurrection? Hallelujah. I feel real good and sanctified and old school this morning. Amen. And I just want to testify to somebody in living faith that God is still real. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless your holy name. Somebody shout, yes, he is. There are some things, just a little bit of it, that I may not know. There are some places I cannot go, but I am sure of this one thing. I'm sure this morning that my God is real, for I can feel him in my soul. Somebody shout, yes, he is. Somebody shout, yes, he is. Now we're going to take it back and we're going to do it old school. Let's do it. He's real to me. Come on. Yes, sir. Yeah. so real.
Lord, it's all.
Oh,
yes, sir. Hey, he's able.
He's able. to your name, God. Y'all make some noise for Jesus in the house. Hallelujah. Glory. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Come on, anybody know he's able? Hallelujah. Won't you put your Abel's hands together? Come on, put them Abel hands together. Hallelujah. Wow. Come on, y'all just took me all the way back. All the way back. Truly, he's able and he's amazing. Can we clap our hands and bless God one more time? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can we celebrate him being an able God, a good God, a mighty God, and an awesome God? Y'all look amazing in this place. Can we celebrate the Lord? Hallelujah. That it is Resurrection Sunday, that we are celebrating a Savior that got up and listen, died for all of you. And we are grateful that you are here in this moment. Amen. Can we clap our hands and bless God one more time? Because truly, God is faithful and consistent. Listen, as you are standing, if you don't have a communion cup in your hand, if you'll just lift your hands and somebody will bring one to you. If you don't have one, somebody will bring one to you. I always appreciate this part because the Lord says, do this as often as you so see fit. And it is a reminder that he shed his blood for all of us. And had he not shed his blood, where would we be? His blood heals, his blood covers, his blood delivers. His blood sets us free. And I am grateful that he covered me under his blood. Because without his blood, where would I be? I think there are a few more people who want to make sure that if you are taking the sacraments, make sure you have that in your hand. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. In the old school church, they would say if you don't got your heart right, then let's make sure we repent first. Come on, come on. Let's make sure we repent first before we take of the sacraments on this morning. Amen. If you don't have one, we want you to raise your hand. Before we take of the sacraments on this morning, I want to pray the prayer of forgiveness. Heavenly Father, we ask that you forgive us for all of our sins, that you wash us and make us clean. And God, today we acknowledge that your Son is the risen Savior. We acknowledge, God, that he not only went down in a grave, but we acknowledge that he got up with all power in his hand. And God, today before we take these sacraments, we ask that you forgive us, that you wash us, that you make us clean. And God, that we do this in remembrance of you, that we remember that your Son died, that we remember that your Son gave his life so that we could live. And God, forgive us for the known and the unknown sins. Forgive us today, wash us and make us clean. And God, we honor you and we praise you in Jesus' name. In that moment, Jesus sat with the disciples. And the Bible says that he took the bread and he broke it. And he said, eat, for this is my body. After breaking the bread, he then took the cup. And he said, this is my blood, drink. Lord, we thank you that you have covered us, that you have kept us. We thank you that his blood keeps us. And God, today I ask that we keep this as a consistent reminder that if it had not been for the blood of God, if it had not been for the power of God, where would we be? We thank you for your blood. We thank you for your anointing, and we thank you for your grace. In Jesus' name, we pray, amen. Can we seal that with celebrating our risen Savior? Just a little bit from day to day. Your hands one more time. Come on, if you know it will never lose its power. Georgia power might go out. Your battery might not start in the morning. But one thing I know about the power of God is that it will never lose its power. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Can we clap our hands one more time and celebrate? Lord, hallelujah, amen. I tell you, I like that we did communion, and now we about to do the offering, amen. So it is offering time in the house. Hallelujah. Want the Lord to cover our seed, cover what we're about to plant, amen. We don't got to take a long time to do it. We know you've already set in your heart what you're going to give, and so Word reminds us to be a cheerful giver. And if you're not cheerful in giving it, amen, you probably should keep it. Amen. But we want all our cheerful givers, because truly, I am a living witness that the more you give, the more he will give it back to you. And so as we're preparing for our seeds on this morning, if you're new online, and if you're new in the building, the information on how to sow is on the screen, and it should be on the screen for you all that are watching us virtually. And for those of you, while you're preparing your seeds, Living Faith is a church. We don't just come in and have church on Sunday mornings, but we're doing stuff in the community all week long, all year long. And I am grateful that we are not just a church that talks about what we do, but we are boots on the ground. Come on, we got some people that can witness that. We are boots on the ground. And I am grateful to be that church, and I am grateful that we are that church that can step out and do what needs to be done in the community. And we can do that because of you. Because you continue to support your church, you continue to stand behind your church, and I am grateful for you and thankful for you that you love us enough to say, listen, my church is on the move, and I want to make sure that my church is doing exactly what they need to be doing. Can we stand, hallelujah, as we're sowing those seeds, hallelujah. Some of y'all hot because y'all got them fascinators on your head, amen. Y'all drawing in that heat. Come on. Come on, if your head was a little smaller. I'm just playing. If you hold your seat up in the air, there's a decree that we say here in the Living Faith Church, and I want you to say that decree with us, especially if you're new here with us, because I believe you should put the word of God in a decree over every seed that you sow. Amen. Hold that seat up in the air and repeat after me. I decree that as I give, the windows of heaven will be open, and God will rebuke the devourer. For my name's sake. This is my seed. God bless me with this seed. And today, I'm planting this seed. It will, it shall, it must reap a harvest in Jesus' name. Amen. If you're sowing monetarily, we ask that you come and place your seed in the basket.
Oh, we're about to take it real old school. Real, real old school. Y'all see these babies? We're gonna take it back 90s. Old school Easter program. Give our babies a hand as they come.
Good morning, class. Great jobs, Yield of Faith youth. We're so glad you all here this morning. Hello.
I'm ready for Easter. I got my yellow dress on and my Easter basket. Now, where are those eggs?
You are beautiful today, Mackenzie, and you look lovely. But we're going to have those Easter egg activities from 1 to 3 today. But right now, we're going to let the class explain to us why we celebrate today. Is that okay? All right, have a seat. Good morning again. Can anyone explain to me, to Mackenzie, what happened? What was the first thing that happened?
God created the earth.
Yes, he did. He created the earth. And then what happened?
There was Adam and Eve, and they meet Adam and Eve. And then they ate the fruit that what they're not supposed to do, and they disobeyed God, so they got separated from him because they ate the fruit, because Satan said that they would know everything and be just like God. So they ate the fruit, so they was separated from God.
Amen. I think you just preached a word on today. That is right. So because they were separated from God, that means they brought sin into the world. What does it mean to sin?
Sin means to do something like to disobey God.
That's right. And because we disobeyed God, we were separated from him. So he had to give us a gift to bring us back to him. And what was that gift?
We ask for forgiveness.
And then what gift did God give us?
God gave us Jesus.
Yes, he did. And that's right. He gave us Jesus. And what did Jesus do for us? I'm going to go on to this side. Let's see who's over here going to answer this for me.
Jesus sacrificed himself.
He sacrificed himself just for us to bring us back to God. So then what happened? Who gonna get me? You don't know what happened? What happened?
On the third day, he rose.
On the third day, he rose. So did he get up on the first day?
No.
What? Did he get up on the second day?
No.
No? Okay. Did he get up on the third day? Yes, yes, and that is why we celebrate Easter on today, because he rose for us. And because he rose, we can have everlasting life, right? Yes. All right, so let us sing Hosanna to the King, and let's worship him together.
Let me hear you make some Holy Ghost crazy noise right now. Let me hear. Come on.
you. All that I'm forever, we worship you. For you are the joy that my soul comes for.
The land that was slain for my sins. Yes,
for the one I am the King of Kings. For the God, everything. All that I'm forever, we worship you. All that I'm forever, we worship you. Kindness and labor and mercy and honor and glory, because you are worthy. We can't sing without you. We can't breathe without you.
We can't sing without you.
All that, all that I love
in this world
is you.
Different things to different people. For the people who believe in Jesus Christ, Easter means the love of God and Jesus Christ. To me, Easter means...
R is for resurrection, which means Jesus came back from the dead to lead the people. By doing this impossible thing, he showed us that his messages and powers are real.
E is for everlasting life. God promised this to everyone who has faith in Jesus Christ. People who follow the words of Jesus will get to live with God forever.
A is for all who believe in the word of Jesus Christ. His lessons and messages are for all people.
S is for sacrifice. Jesus Christ gave up his life to pay for the sins of all people because he loves us. He gave something important so we wouldn't have to.
T is for trust. If we trust in God and Jesus, we can live a happy life. Trust means being sure that God and Jesus will be there for us even when we can't see them.
E is for eternity. God says we can live forever with him if we follow Jesus Christ. And eternity never ends and includes when we are alive after we die.
Good job. Again. There you go.
Do it again. They want you to do it again.
R is for resurrection, which means Jesus came back from the dead to lead the people. By doing this impossible thing, he showed us that his messages and powers are real.
Join us as we watch the Kingdom Worshippers minister the Easter story. But remember, it all started at the cross.
Of the Lord, I go to the songs that have the power, songs that deal with the cross, because we can't get so advanced that we forget the cross of Calvary. I don't hear you in here. We can't become so progressive that we forget it's the cross that saves. It's the cross that purchased our salvation. It was his death on the cross that made it so that we can have a right to salvation and eternity. It was the death, it was the bloody, gory, wonderful cross. Then they would say, have the cross. But these are some blood-washed, Holy Ghost-filled Pastor Ann. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died on the cross. And I know it was the blood for me. But then he rose up from the dead. And I know, I know, I know, I know it was the
Anybody know the blood still works? Hallelujah. Can we clap our hands and bless God? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. If you'll do me a favor, if you would stand to your feet. I want to take this next 50 seconds to just lift our hands and thank God for allowing us to come into this space safely. It is not just another Easter service. It is not just another resurrection service. But it is a service where we come to worship God in spirit and in truth. While your hands are lifted, I want you to think about a moment or a time that the Lord brought you through or brought you out. And I want you to begin to tell him thank you. Now, this is not a neighbor's moment or a participatory moment where you would talk to your neighbor. This is a moment for you and yourself. That only you know what you've been through and only you know what God brought you out of. And so I want you to put a thank you on your lips. Not for your neighbor, but for what you know that you should have died through. For what you know that you should have lost your mind through. Come on, I'm going to get you there in a second. But I want you to get a thank you on your lips because your neighbor has no idea who they're standing beside. They have no idea what you've been through and what you've come out of, what you've lost. You're smiling, but they have no idea what you've lost. You're looking good today, but they have no idea what you've been through. They have no idea what the pain is. And in the next second, we're going to put a thank you on our lips because some of you literally, if it had not been for the power of God, you would not be standing in this room on this morning. But because God had his hands on you, you are standing here. And some of you are tired. Some of you are weary. Some of you don't even know how you're making it. But you are standing here because of his power and because of his presence. So as you lift your hands as a sign of victory and not as a sign of surrender, as you lift your hands this morning for the next 20 seconds, I want you to get a thank you on your lips that doesn't have anything to do with anybody else. But a thank you on your lips that God has done so much for you, that God has made so many ways for you and done things that are unprecedented in your life. And I want us to be able to let heaven know that we appreciate him for everything that he has done. All right, y'all ready? I want you to lift your hands. Come on, lift your hands. And I want you to begin to tell him thank you. Come on, go, 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 go. Come on, thank you for waking me up. Thank you for keeping my children safe. Thank you for not letting me be in that shooting. Thank you, God, for allowing the bullet to miss me. Thank you, God, that I still got my mind. Thank you, Lord, that I still stand here smiling. Thank you, God, that the depression didn't take me out, that I was able to get up today with a smile on my face. Thank you, Lord, that you are consistent with me, that you are grateful to me, that you are kind to me. Come on, I need to hear some voices in this room that are thankful and consistent. God, I thank you that you never left me. I thank you, God, that you love me even when I didn't love myself. I thank you, God, that when I should have quit, when I tried to quit, when I tried to stop, God, that you held me down and you kept pushing me. And God, I honor you and I thank you because you are good. 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 I need some people in here that you've almost lost your mind, but can you get a thank you on your lip that you are standing here in your right mind, that you are standing here in your sound mind? We're just praying. We're going. Come on here. That I'm thankful, God, that the thing didn't take me out, that the drugs didn't take me out, that the alcohol didn't take me out, that the cocaine didn't take me out. I'm thankful, God, that I'm standing here in this moment. I'm thankful that the relationship did not take me out. Come on, 20 seconds. We almost there. We almost there. We almost there. We almost there. Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you for being consistent with me. Thank you for being consistent with me. Even when I was not consistent with you. Thank you for pushing me even when I wanted to give up. And I appreciate you, God, because God, you are good. You are awesome. You are mighty. And Lord, we bless you for your goodness. And we bless you for your grace. And God, we honor you. Can you do me a favor and clap your hands and bless God? Can you do me a favor and bless your God? Your neighbor has no idea what you came out of and what you came through. But some of you all in this room, you are a miracle standing. And I'm grateful to be standing beside a miracle on this morning. Come on, clap your hands one more time. Hallelujah. Before you take your seats, as you know, there are always so many things that are going on in our church, and I'm not going to read everything that's going on here, and then we'll quickly jump into our scripture. Can we celebrate God for our babies? I'm always grateful because I learned everything I learned about standing in front of people in the church. And I learned how to speak oratorically in the church. So I'm grateful that we're bringing those things back to the church and that our children are able to stand in this capacity. And when you stand in this capacity, when they go out in the world, they won't be afraid of that stage because they've been able to do it in God's house. Amen. And so I'm grateful for them and honored for them. Our Easter egg hunt is going to happen immediately after service. So immediately after service, we're going to have the Easter egg hunt. Please don't forget about Bible study this Wednesday night at 7 p.m. We're going to be right here in this sanctuary. Last week, we went to our Palmetto campus, and God met us. For those of you that came with us, absolutely amazing service. And then on April the 14th, I am pleased, I am excited, and I cannot wait. We are ordained some ministers and elders. Yeah. So April the 14th at 10 a.m., we want you right here to celebrate with us. That's going to be a major day, and we are grateful that those individuals have made it through our MIT, and they have matriculated on so God can graduate them and help them be what has to be done. Now listen, we're going to have a spring fling. We're going to clean on April the 20th from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. They need all available hands. We just want to clean, and we want to make sure that our church is presentable so we can get together with that. And so we want you to be here on April the 20th between 12 and 2 p.m. Our women's ministry are having a spring brunch. Can we celebrate God for our women's ministry on April the 27th at 11 a.m. You can RSVP by texting brunch to 404-361-0812, and that brunch is $15. Amen. Amen. And then lastly, our seniors who don't look like seniors, amen, 62 and older, of their ministry, they're going to be having a give me my flowers while I can still smell them. It's a flowers affair. It's going to be Saturday, May the 11th at 12 p.m. Text flowers to 404-361-0812. If you are not a part of a ministry in this church, please become a part of the ministry. You can text 404-361-0812 if you are not a part of a ministry here in this church, because we want you to be connected. If you're not a part of prayer, we want you to join prayer. If you're not a part of the pantry, the dance ministry, the greeters ministry, the nurse ministry, the ushers ministry, the youth ministry, the choir ministry, the media ministry, amen, the men's ministry, we want you to join all of those things because we want you to be a part of that. Amen. And please don't forget, this Saturday we're having 5 a.m. prayer. Amen. Because we believe in prayer and we believe in the power of God. Amen. Everybody's standing all over the room. Everybody's standing all over the room. Hallelujah. For the next 15 minutes, amen, I'm going to stand before you. Matthew 26. For those of you that are on the email list, you already have the notes. Matthew 26 and 14. This morning, I want to talk to you about how God is going to use sabotage to catapult you to your next destiny. If you've never been sabotaged, keep waiting because you will. If you've never been set up, keep waiting because you will be set up. So Matthew 26 and 14 says, then one of the 12, the one called Judas the Iscariot, went to the chief priests and asked, what are you willing to give me if I deliver him over to you? So they counted him out 30 pieces of silver. 16 says, from then on, Judas watched for an opportunity to hand him over. There are some people that are watching you, and they are just waiting for the right opportunity to hand you over. We're going to talk on this morning about the setup, set the setup for the setup. Read it again. The setup, set the setup for the setup. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness and your mercy. We thank you for your kindness. We thank you, God, that you have allowed us to come into this collective space to worship you. Because God, you are good, you are awesome, and you are mighty. And Lord, today I pray that ears, eyes, and hearts will be open to what you have to say to them on this morning. God, we are grateful and we are thankful that you are good, that you are kind, that you are consistent. And God, we ask that you give us what we need from this word. We honor you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Won't you celebrate God as you go to your seat? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. If you're in this room, I want you to raise your hand if you've ever been sabotaged, set up. Can we see? I want to get a little pulse on some folks that have been sabotaged and set up. And y'all got my hands waving over in the balcony. I see some people over here. Amen. Let me see some people over there. Amen. If you've ever been set up or sabotaged. Now, let me say this. People that have never been set up or sabotaged, they're usually not doing anything. I'll say that again. If you've never been set up, if you've never been sabotaged, you're probably not doing anything. And the devil isn't going to go after anybody that he already has. And the unfortunate thing is that some of you are already on his team is the reason why he's not bothering you. It's all right. We're going to slow walk this dog today. And so the reason why some of you have never experienced sabotage, never experienced somebody coming against you, is because you're probably not doing anything significant enough for anybody to even come at you or to try to grab anything from you. Now, every year we know the word. We know Jesus went in the grave and he died and all of that great stuff. But that's not what I'm going to talk about today. Today I want to talk about the power of sabotage and how God will use sabotage to oftentimes catapult you or push you in the direction that God wants you to be in. Now, the first thing that we have to understand is that God allows Jesus to pick his team. And when he goes to pick his team, Judas is one of the first people that he picks to be on his team. So he picks the individual that's going to sabotage him. He picks the individual that's going to set him up. But what we do a lot of times when God says, I want you to pick your team, we try to pick people that we want to assumingly walk with us consistently and move with us. But what if I told you that when you pick your team, you shouldn't always pick people that like you and say yes? Y'all better talk back to me. You shouldn't always pick people that like you and that say yes. You should sometimes pick somebody that asks questions and asks you why and question what it is that you are doing. So God allows him to pick his team, because in picking his team, the word says that he chooses Judas as one of the disciples and as one of the individuals that are on his team, because he knows that Judas is going to push him to the place that God has called him to be. Now, I got to say this before we keep going in the word. Some of us, all we want on our team are people to say yes and amen. You don't need people like that on your team. You need somebody to call you out on your stuff. Let me look over here to this side because y'all real quiet. I'm going to get up in a minute, but I figure since y'all sit, now sit. I'm just saying, you can't always have somebody on your team that says yes. Sometimes you need somebody on your team that says, I don't know about this. And the reason why you need a I don't know about this person, because what it does is that it opens the creativity up, and maybe you were going to do it one way, but now since they're on your team, you got to do it another way. Let me break this down even more, that some of you, it was good that that woman showed up because you stopped being a wife. And so you needed the pressure. Uh-oh, come on. Y'all gotta talk to me. So you needed the pressure because now you got me, so you stopped doing what it is that you were supposed. Y'all see how quiet it is in here? No, I need you to do the same thing when you got me, to do the same thing to keep y'all. I ain't got not one man standing up, and I'm doing this for y'all. If I don't got this mic on Sunday, if y'all don't get y'all black behind, come on. And so sometimes God will send healthy competition to make you get back on your post. Uh-oh, come on. God will send healthy competition to make you get back on your post and to make you start doing what God has called you to do. There are some people in here, you done got sorry, you done got lazy, and God got to send some healthy competition to make you get back on your game. Because I got it now. I'm good now. No, some of you have gotten complacent at what God has called you. And let me tell you how we've gotten complacent. Just because you have gotten the career, just because you have become successful, just because you are doing better than you were before, does not mean you become complacent. But some of us have become complacent, and we are now stuck in the place that we are in, and we're no longer doing no more than what we're doing because we're now just getting by. So God has to send healthy competition to now force us to do what we should have been doing all along. So now the word says that God allows Jesus, and I need you to hear me with this, God allows Jesus to pick the person that is going to sabotage him. God is allowing some of you to pick the person that is going to set you up. But the setup is, it's just a divine moment for God to push you into the place where God has called you to be. Now let's walk the word. The word says that Judas is hanging out with Jesus, going to church with Jesus, doing all this stuff with Jesus, but he's also going behind Jesus' back. He's also going behind his back, and now the word says, and I don't even know how he slipped off, because the word says there's some kind of way he slipped off and started talking to the Pharisees and the Sadducees. And they said to him, how much is it going to cost for us to buy you or to pay you to sell God out? And the word says that Judas is there. He says, name your price. And the Bible says that they give him 30 pieces of silver, which is equate to about $40,000 during that time. So they give him this $40,000, and they says, look, if you sell him out, then we're going to, but this is the great thing. The great thing is that they pay him the money because they know that he's going to get the job done. How do I know that they know that he's going to get the job done? Is because you never pay nobody before they do the work first. But because Judas had a track record of setting people up. Y'all won't talk to me in here. Because Judas had a track record of messing people up. They knew he was going to get the job done, so they paid him before he ever even did the work. Now, all of you in here, you are never going to pay anybody until they do the work first, unless you work with them prior to, and you know what they are capable of. And so the Sadducees and the Pharisees knew what Judas was capable of, and they knew that he was going to do and get the job done, so they paid him in advance. What if I told you that if you ran down your friend list in your phone, maybe you should look at some of those people that have a pay advance to already set you up and put you in the place that you are in? The word says that Judas takes his money, and when he takes his money, the word says that he goes back to business as usual. He shows up to the communion service. He shows up to the healing service. He shows up to every single thing. And see, that's why I'm not impressed with people just showing up. Because you just showing up just means that you're working on me to set me up, because you keep showing up, because some people are showing up and waiting on that right and opportune moment to do what it is that needs to be done. The word says that Judas shows up, he keeps showing up, he keeps showing up, and all he's doing is gathering information so he can take it back to them, because they had to know where Jesus was in order to get here. So he says, look, I'm going to gather information, and I'm going to let you know when the time is right. I'm going to let you know when the time is right. I'm going to let you know when you are going to be where you're going to be. And let me tell you, to be completely honest with you, I'm always afraid sometimes when new people come in the circle. Because when new people come in the circle, I don't know who you are. I got to learn who you are. I got to make sure I trust who you are and learn what it is and do all of those things. And I got to find out why you're here and find out what you're doing here. Come on. See, some of y'all ain't asking them questions because y'all want a friend so bad. I don't need a friend no bad. I'm in this season where I be doing background checks. I be like, who is you? Where you came from? What you doing? And why are you here? And the reason why I'm questioning why you here is because you know I'm on my come up and I'm on my way to somewhere else. You got to be careful when people show up. They weren't here when you were down here. Now all of a sudden you want to pop up, bring me a pie and bring me juice and tell me how amazing I am. Nope. I need you to stay right where you are, because you were not here when I didn't have all of this and when doing all of this. Let me go rock with the people that have been rocking with me when I was on welfare, food stamps, toe up and raggedy and couldn't buy a quick weed. Preacher, better than you responded. Let me go grab them. Tap somebody and say, stick with what you know. Because some of these new people are about to set you up. Let me calm down. Let me calm down. Because some of y'all want a friend so bad until God is saying to you, you don't need another friend. Now, all of a sudden, some of y'all looking funny because you looking around. I got a new friend. No. You don't need a new friend. You need to question why they popped up in this season, in this moment, and this time of your life. Some of y'all getting ready to go to the next level, and they popping up because they want to leech on to what they know and what they see that you are going. But you know what I do now? Now I'll be like, nope, you can't go with me. You can't go with me. You can't go with me. And you don't have an application or a permission slip to be on this bus. Mess around and go on the right trip with the wrong people. Some of y'all are on the right trip, but you got the wrong people. You ain't gave me no gas money. We done stopped by Popeye's Chicken, and I done got a two-piece. Come on here in a lemonade with light ice, and you talking about you want a number 6, and you ain't gave me no money yet. You need to drop those jokers off, because what God has for you is for you. Who am I talking to in here? I need somebody that says, I'm going somewhere, but I ain't going with you. Let me chill out. And the reason why I'm trying to chill out is because I know that in due season, I'm getting ready to reap if I faint not. And what I reap ain't what you are about to reap. If some of you could just stop being lonely
Let me talk to the balcony. They've been drinking all night. Let me talk to the balcony. If some of you could just stop being lonely for 30 seconds and just say, I love me and I don't need nobody to go with me on this next level that God has called me to go to, and I'm going to be selfish. Now, all of a sudden, oh, y'all chill. Now, all of a sudden, the word says that he takes money for hire, and the job has not been done. There are some people that are asking you questions and screenshotting your stuff and saving it for later. Come on, can we break it to common day terms? And saving it for later. So for when you get to this level, this is why I keep telling y'all, stop putting your body on Snapchat. Come on here. It ain't disappeared, it's still there. Y'all don't hear me? I could have another phone and record you preaching better than y'all respond. Because I know where you're going. Let me get some ammunition. And see, the reason why some of you can't consume this is because you're not going anywhere. But when you start going somewhere, you start gauging your conversation. Somebody had called me the other day, and I said, they asked me a question. I said, we can talk about that in person. But I ain't talking to you about that on this phone. I don't know who you got over there listening to me. I don't know who you record. Come on here. I'm trying to help some of y'all in here. Because some of y'all, you sit beside somebody that is dangerous. Well, what you think about so-and-so and so? I don't know. I'm just praying and believing that God is going to bring them through and bring them out. But some of y'all fall in that trap. Don't fall. Somebody said, don't fall. Don't fall. Come, because some of us love gossip so much, we fall. Some of us love, oh, girl, you got to tell me what's going on. You fall. No. I need you to say, wait. If we won't talk about this, I'll talk to you face to face. And some of y'all, I need to check if you see and you got a wire on. I'm the police now, so I'm acting crazy. Come on here. I need to check and see if y'all got a wire on. Because some of y'all, and let me tell you about those wire people. Wire people are only there to get the information that they want to take it back to the person that they're working for. Some of y'all don't need a wire. You can repeat that thing back verbatim. With emotions, come on. Just say it just how they want to hear it and just how they want to do it. So the word says, and we're almost done, the word says that now sabotage is the best competitive advantage for Jesus because he cannot win any other way. And what if I told you that sabotage is now about to become the best competitive advantage for you because you may or may not win any other way. So word says that Judas gets paid prior to doing the work, and he says to them, I'll hit you up when he's in his most vulnerable state. I'll call you when he's at his weakest. The word says Jesus is depressed because God is not speaking to him. God is not saying anything to him, and the word says that he is now lamenting about dying on the cross. And I need you to hear me and hear me clearly. The Son of God, his own Father, isn't speaking to him. So his own Father isn't saying anything to him, and the word says that Jesus becomes depressed, and he goes to a garden called Gethsemane. And the word says the Garden of Gethsemane is a place where people not only prayed, but it's also a place where people lamented when people died. walk with me. And so the Bible says that he goes to a place called Gethsemane. He goes to the Garden of Gethsemane. Now hear this. The Garden of Gethsemane is a place not only where people prayed, but it's also a place where people mourned. Yes. And so now Jesus goes to pray and mourn his own death. And he's hoping that God would speak to him in this moment and in this death. The word says that while Jesus is praying, the word says, listen, check this, they die in their sleep. They're not even worried about what's going on with him. And the word says that Judas says to them, he says, the one that I greet with a holy kiss, that's the one. And so the Bible says that when it was time for Jesus to be set up and sold out, that Judas did as he had always done, greeted him with love and with compassion. Yes. Because this is the thing that I need you to understand in here today. Some of us are mixed up with relationships and friends because we get love and compassion. Some of y'all don't need love and compassion. Some of you need a little pushing, a little no, a little anger, a little abrasion. But the Bible says that he gives Jesus love and compassion. He said, the one that I greet with the holy kiss and the one that I hug, that's the one that I want you to captivate, and that's the one that I want you to grab. I'm tripping because you already done got paid to set me up, and you've been hanging around me this whole time. Look like me, walk like me, talk like me, move like me. We go to church together. But now, all of a sudden, you've gotten paid. Somebody done paid you off. I ain't done enough for you. I ain't walked with you enough and showed you who I was. Until now, you got to go. You got to go and bet and spend money and now pay me off. And now, and the word says that he walking around with a fat bank in his pocket and smiling, ain't paid tithes or nothing. Come on here. Ain't gave the Lord nothing. The Lord said he walking around with this money in his pocket to sabotage Jesus all at the same time. But here's the fun part about the text. Jesus already knew who was going to sabotage him. And see, the problem with some of us is that if you learn how to get in position and learn how to play chess, you can choose your enemy, and your enemy can really put you in the place that you're supposed to be in and where God has called you. The Bible says, hear me, the Bible says that Jesus already knew that Judas was going to betray him, and he knew that Peter was going to deny him three times. And he told them at the table, he says, you're going to deny me and you're going to sell me out. They both denied it. But Jesus says, I picked you, so I know you. You thought you picked me, but I picked you. And since I picked you, what you thought you had on me, you don't got on me because I picked you. I need some players in here. I ain't talking nobody. I need somebody in here that know how to play the game. Because the reality of it is that you can't trick a trick. Hello, somebody in here. You got to understand that if you know the game, play the game, live the game, walk the game, Jesus says, I chose you. And because I chose you, I'm about to show you that me choosing you is gonna catapult me to the place that God has called me to be in. You want a friend when you really need somebody to move you to your destiny. Y'all don't want to talk to me in here. You looking for somebody to rub elbows with, and God says, I got a game player that's about to sell you into where you're supposed to go. Jesus says, I chose you, and since I chose you, I know you. Yeah. One of the fun things about being able to know the game, and I always tell this story, my wife tell this story, when we first started dating, we went bowling, and I wanted to make sure, and I would bowl all the time, but I wanted to make sure that she won. And I wanted to make sure that she thought that I was no good at bowling. All right, all I chose the game. I chose the place because I had played there before. And so you got to understand, because Jesus was connected to God, the game had already been played before. Let me calm down. And so we go bowling, right? We go bowling. I'm throwing gutter balls, and she doing strikes, and she doing all of this, and I'm telling her to position this and do all of this and this, that, and the way. And then, see, this is why you got to remember when you tell lies. When we left there, she was winning, she was happy. But then when we got invited to go out with our friends one weekend, and I don't forgot. Because I'm with my boys, y'all don't hear me. I don't forgot that I don't know how to play. I grabbed my ball, I don't forgot about the lie. Come on here, it was in the sea of forgetfulness. I done forgot about the lie. I grabbed my ball. I did my little toot toot toot. Come on here. And I said, woo! And that thing hit a strike. That woman was looking at me like, I know. You told me that you didn't know how to play this game. She said, I thought you said that you couldn't play. I thought you said, I said, well, you know. What I meant was, come on, y'all, I need somebody in here. See, you got to understand that when you played the game before, you can control the narrative. Because I've played the game. Jesus says, okay. He says, I chose you. He says, I chose you. Specifically for this moment and for this season. But when we choose people to be in our lives, when we choose people to go to where we are, they cannot just be yes people. Word says, because sabotage, and this is just the point, sabotage provides a reality check on where we are. And sometimes we need sabotage to give us a reality check on where we are. Now let's close this thing. The word says that the night happens. And the word says, hear me, the word says that Jesus has now came to his final moment. He is now in his final ascension to the cross. And the word says that Judas does exactly what he says that he's going to do, and he sells Jesus out. And now it is crucifixion day. Jesus and his mother and her friends are all standing at the altar or standing at the cross, waiting on Jesus to be crucified and waiting on Jesus to die. And the word says, as Jesus is going up the hill called Golgotha, the Bible says that he becomes weak and another man comes to help him carry the cross all the way. Because the reality of what was going on is that if you were a thief or somebody being crucified, you had to carry your own cross that you were going to be crucified on. Word says that he carries the cross, and when he carries the cross, the word says that, of course, they nail him to the cross, they hang him up in front of everybody, and when they hang him up in front of everybody, they want to ensure that this is the man that said that he was the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. What if I told you that you may be hanging on life's cross right now, but that's not where you're going to die? That's not the end of where you are, and it's not the end of where God placed you and where you're going to be. The word says that they hang him on the cross. There's a man on the left talking crazy, and a man on the right, they're talking with sins. The Bible says that the man on the left says, if you really are the Son of God, why don't you command that these stones be made bread? Let me say this to you. There are some people that will challenge you in your moment of adversity, and they'll make you question whether or not God is really real in your life. And some of you are questioning or not whether God is really real in your life, saying, God, okay, God, are you really real? And are you going to really do what you say that you're going to do? The man on the right says, he literally says to him, he says, look, I just want to be with you in paradise. I don't want to be nowhere else. I just want to be with you in paradise, and that's where I want to go. Jesus leans over to him. He says, you're going to be with me in paradise. And then Jesus, in that moment, he dies. He drops his head in the lock of his shoulders. They wrap him up. They throw him in a borrowed tomb. tomb by Lazarus, and the women are coming every single day to the tomb. Hear me, not the men, but the women. They're coming every single day to the tomb. And the word says that one day when they got to the tomb, that the stone had been rolled away. And the soldiers that were guarding the tomb were on the ground asleep. And so initially, Martha says, somebody has stole Jesus. Jesus pops around the corner and he says, ain't nobody stole me. He said, ain't nobody stole me. He says, here I am right here. He says, they set me up to do the next thing for this current generation who doesn't really know God and don't really understand who I am. I die for the people in 2024 so that they can understand that, yep, you're walking around free, but it's because I died for you and it's because I gave my life for you. And guess what? I'm coming back for them too one day, and I'm going to start in the church because that's the place that I'm looking for, and that's the place that I'm going. Now let me close with this. You will never, ever go to the next level in your life until you are sabotaged first. You will never experience elevation until you are sabotaged first. And let me tell you something. Being sabotaged by somebody on the outside, it don't hurt. But it hurts because you know me. It hurts because we ate together. We walked together. We cried together. I told you my secret. And so now it hurts. Because your greatest adversity ain't coming from the outside. Your greatest adversity is gonna come from the inside. And until you understand that now, that it is the people on the inside of your life that are going to sabotage you and push you into your next. But the thing about it is, you gotta be able to accept what's about to happen. You got to be able to accept what's about to take place, because God is about to take you to that next and to that moment and to that individual. And let me say this to you. I used to never be a confrontational person. I hate conflict. And I used to always avoid it, Elder Jackson, at all costs. And so when conflict showed up, I used to never want to deal with the conflict, and I used to always run from it because I used to say, no, I'll just let that. But there are some things that you have to face in order to move forward in your life. And this is the thing, what we do is we don't face it. We just stay there, and we just become stuck, and we don't move forward. But for all of the individuals that are in this room that don't like conflict, let me encourage you, face it. Challenge it. Step in his face and say, listen, I need to handle this. As we close on this afternoon, for every person in this room that knows that next level is on your life, will you lift your hand? You know that you're about to do something crazy. But you also know that there's a setup coming with where you are going. Not only is there a setup, but there's a war coming that you don't know if you're going to be able to win or conquer. And some of you, the war going on in your house right now. The dissension is going on in your house right now. But today I'm here to tell you that God is about to give you the power to step into your next. And your next is not coming, but your next is right in your face. But it requires you to accept that this storm, that this battle, that this challenge, that this moment of where everybody won't love me will come. Because when I got in this, I'm like, man, everybody gonna love me. I'm a preacher now. But I found out I took the wrong job. But when I kept going and when I kept moving, I kept understanding that no elevation comes without a fight. That no elevation comes without something going on in the spirit that says, I got to challenge where you are. For every person in this room that know you're going to a next level, I want you to stand to your feet. For every person in this room that you know that you are going to the next level, I want you to stand to your feet. As you're standing, I want you to prepare your heart and your mind to be victorious and understand what God is about to bring you through and bring you out of. The challenge that we face is that, God, can I win this battle to get to that next place? And some of us, we literally run out of juice on our way there. And we say, okay, God, I've been beat upside the head, I've been jumped on, I've been all of this stuff, and I just don't know if I got enough in me to handle another no. I don't know if I got enough in me to handle another disappointment. I don't know if I got enough in me to handle this not going in the direction that I wanted to go in. Real quickly, I'm going to do three calls to the altar. Call number one is for that individual that says, I know that I'm next, but I'm standing in my own way. You keep telling yourself you can't do it. You keep telling yourself that you can't make it happen. But today I want you to get out of your own way. If that's you, the altar is open to you. Come on, the altar is open to you. It ain't nobody else. It's you standing in your way. Not nobody else. It's you that you've convinced yourself that you can't start the business. You've convinced yourself that if I quit, what am I going to do if I quit? You've convinced yourself that I don't know what I can do. If you're standing in your own way, I want to open the altar to you. I got two more calls. Been standing in your own way. I keep telling myself that I can't do it. I keep asking myself why. But today, I gotta get out of my way. Get out of your way. My second call. To the person that says, to be honest with you, Pastor, I've just given up on my dreams. I've given up on trying to be an entrepreneur. I've given up on trying to do anything. And I'm just stuck. If that's you, the altar is open to you. You just quit. You don't even know where to go, where to stand, where to do, what level to take. Come on, is that you? The altar is open to you. I'm stuck. I don't know what's next. I don't know what I've been called to do. I don't know what my purpose is. I don't know why I'm here. Thank you, Jesus. If that's you, the altar is open to you on this morning. It's all right. It's all right. Ain't nobody studying people beside us. If we the job is to get you unstuck. The job is to get you moving. The job is to get you from that place that you are in. I said I had one more call, but I actually got two more calls. My next call is for the person that anxiety keeps jumping on you and you keep having panic attacks. Come on.
I need you at this altar. Come on here. We're going to bind this anxiety off of you. We're going to bind these panic attacks off of you. Come on, no more anxiety. No more anxiety. No more anxiety. No more anxiety. Come on, and anxiety just grips you and you get stuck and you don't know what to do. But today we declare that no more anxiety will be on your life. We declare that you will not be afraid to step out, that you will not be afraid to do what he's called you to do. Come on, come on, come on. We bind anxiety and fear. Come on. We bind anxiety and fear. No more anxiety, no more fear, no more anxiety, and no more fear. Lastly, my last call is that if you are in this room and you don't know who Jesus is, I want to invite you so you can know who he is, your personal, as your personal savior. And some of y'all say, well, Pastor, I know who Jesus is, but I ain't really connected to the church. I'm not really having a relationship anymore. If you've lost your relationship with Christ, I want you to come because I want to pray for you. If you've lost your relationship with Christ, I want you to come because I want to pray with you. Come on, y'all know I believe in taking time at the altar. If you've lost your relationship and you know that you are no longer in relations with God, come on, I want to invite you to this altar. Come on, can we celebrate God as they are coming? As they are coming. As they are coming. I promise I'll have you out of here in the next 10 minutes, but if you'll hold the music for just 1 second. The other day I was in prayer and I saw the enemy attacking my generation. And I mean attacking us to the point where we looked as though that we were drowning. And it was crazy because God took me in the spirit and he showed me a bunch of ants who were carrying something. And then water came and consumed them. And so I started doing research because after the water consumed them, the ants were kind of like all stuck together in one place. And so I started doing research after I prayed that the enemy was trying to attack this generation and attack this culture and attack us and try to leech onto us and drown us out and trying to keep us from doing what it is that God has called us to do. The money been crazy. The society has been crazy. And we've had to live through a lot of things and walk through a lot of things. And so I was doing some research and the ants, and was talking about how the ants, when the ants get together in a whole bunch of water, they let go of what they're holding on to and they start holding on to each other so they can survive through the water. And so one of the things that I'm saying to you today is that what's about to happen in the next moment is that we're about to let go of what we thought that we were going to carry and what we thought that we were going to hold on to. And today, we're about to pray through together, collectively as a group, and we're about to bond together. And what should have drowned you can't drown you. And what should have took you out is not going to take you out because we are going to do this together. Now, let me take you to the word that says, where two or three touch and agree, he'll be in the midst. And then he says, one can chase 1,000, but two can put 10,000 to flight. Now, there's more than two people standing at this altar on this afternoon. Now, I need you to understand that what comes out of your mouth next is what God is going to manifest. So if doubt comes out of your mouth, then God can't manifest that because God don't deal with that. God is not a God of confusion, but we deal with a God that says whatever you speak, if you speak life into your destiny, that's what God is going to give you. And so what I want to teach you is not, it's all not always about the preacher laying hands on you, but I want to teach you how to talk to your God and how to have a relationship with your God just by you simply opening your mouth.
And just by you simply talking to him and saying, God, now if you did it for all those people, there surely there has to be something that you can do for me and make ways for me. Every single one of you that are standing at this altar right now, and there are some more people who should be at this altar, but you are not at this altar, and I'll give you time to get to this altar, because the enemy has tried to attack you and stop you to keep you from being everything that God called you to be. And let me say this to every single person that's standing here. Last year almost took you out, but this year is already starting to be crazy. But let me tell you what's about to happen before you leave this room. Before you leave this room, the power of God is about to arrest the second quarter and the next quarter, and what was will never be again. I'm prophesying to you already. We don't need no music yet, but I need you to hear me clearly at what I'm saying. See, some of you had a tumultuous year last year. Your money, your mind, your relationships, your house, everything was crazy. But this year, God is about to set some stuff in order, and it's going to come straight from you and straight out of you, because the power of God is a God of order and a God of power. So today, as you're standing here, I'm declaring over you that last season that you just walked out of, because guess what? Tomorrow is April 1st. So not only is tomorrow April 1st, but tomorrow starts the next quarter that has to happen for the year. Which means I get to start new already, because tomorrow is a new day and tomorrow is something new. And tomorrow is also April Fool's. And some of y'all, the enemy is playing tricks on you. And it feels like an April Fool's joke. But let me tell you that you are standing here because God is about to do what he said that he's going to do in your life. So today, as I wait on some more people to come to this altar who should have came to this altar. And that's why I'm talking, because I'm waiting. I'm waiting because your next is tied to you being at this altar. I'm waiting because your next is tied to you coming and standing and let God know that I'm ready for whatever you're about to do in my life. That everything that you said that you were going to do, I know that you are going to do it. But what I'm not going to do is leave this building, leave this what we call Easter service, and God not give me what I've been praying for. And God not give me what I've been asking for. And God not do what he's going to do in my life. So we're so used to church being this way, that way, but sometimes God will have us do things in an unorthodox way because he wants us to understand that he is still God. I'm still waiting. I'm still waiting. I'm still waiting. Y'all can step up a little bit. Come on. So the people behind you, I'm still waiting. And the reason why I'm waiting is because your destiny is tied to this altar. The altar is a place of alteration. Your destiny is tied to this altar. And let me tell you what God is doing. God is about to alter your life because you decide to make the step to come to this altar. And you decide to make the step to say, God, I am ready for change. You would not be standing here if you were not ready for change. I've been stuck so many times in my life, but I had to go to God and say, okay, God, when are you going to do this? When are you going to make this happen? Yes, I'm still waiting because I'm still talking. I'm still waiting because I'm still talking, that your destiny is tied to this altar. And some of you haven't been to church in a while, and I need you to get to this altar because your destiny is tied to your next. And right here is where God is going to do what he said that he's going to do in your life. Come on, people are coming. As they're coming. As they're coming, as they're coming, as they're coming, as they're coming. See, we're so used to music, so we don't know how to respond. But you ought to be responding to their souls standing at this altar. Responding that there are people's lives that are about to be changed. Come on, they're coming. Come on, they're coming. You're not going through the rest of this year the same as you did the year prior to. I'm telling you, all of you that have had a crazy year, a crazy season, a crazy time, and listen, some of y'all keep making the same mistakes over and over and over and over and over again, but God is about to give you the power to say no this time. Somebody about to be upset with you. Somebody is about to be mad with you because this time you're not going back. Come on, you're not going back. You're not going back. We're almost there. Come on, we're almost there. Come on, we're almost there. We're almost there. Come on, I'm waiting on a few more people. I hear you, Holy Ghost. Come on, I'm just taking my time. I'm waiting on a few more people. Come on, I hear you, Jesus. Come on, come on. I'm waiting on a few more people. Thank you. I wish somebody would have took this kind of time with me. Come on, you just can't rush this moment. You just can't rush this moment. You just can't rush this moment. Your next is tied to this. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Every person that's standing, we're going to pray. For every person that's standing, I want you to take your hands and put it over your mouth. Come on. You have to govern what comes out of your mouth. Some of you keep speaking doubt. But today I'm laying hands on my lips. Today I'm laying hands on my mouth. And today I am not about to speak negativity. I'm not about to speak what I don't see. Come on, come on, come on. Because some of y'all spoke this stuff into your life. You spoke this negativity into your life. So now we got to command our tongue to get in order. Come on, we got to command our mouth to get in order. Because what you've been saying and what you've been doing has been manifested in the heavens. And so today you're fixing what you say, fixing what you do. Come on, you got your hands over your mouth. Because God is changing how you say what you say and how you do what you do. Because this time, when you open your mouth, you're going to speak victory over your life. You're going to speak breakthroughs over your life. You won't speak death. You won't speak sadness. You won't say, I don't have. You won't say, I can't do it. You won't say, I don't know. You will say, I am able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that God could ask or think. You will say, God, whatever you want me to do, you can do it. You will say, I will live and not die. You will say, God, you are able to do the impossible in my life. Come on, hands up. Come on, put your hands on your mouth. The next time you open your mouth, which will be in this service, the next time you open your mouth, which will be in this service, the next time you open your mouth, and I'm going to give you a second to open your mouth. When you open your mouth, you're about to change the narrative of what God is about to do in your life. Now, this is what I want you to do. Take your hand down. Now, I want you to put your name in the atmosphere, Jeremy Tuck. Come on, put your name in the atmosphere, Jeremy Tuck. Let me tell you what you're doing. You're sending your name to rooms that your feet cannot touch. Come on, you're sending your names to angels. Come on here, come on here, come on. Can we say our name one more time? Jeremy Tuck, come on, throw your name. Come on, throw your name. Come on, you're about to do something crazy. You're about to do what has never been done before. Come on, Jeremy Tuck, come on, throw your name. Throw your name, 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 come on. Now you're going to throw your name in the atmosphere, and then you're going to come right behind it, and you're going to tell God what you want him to do in your life. Now I need you to participate with me. You're going to throw your name in the atmosphere, and then I want you to start telling God what he's going to do in your life. Y'all ready? Come on, throw your name in the atmosphere. Jeremy Tuck, I need you to make ways for me. I need you to provide for me. I need you to help me be victorious. I need depression to fall off of me. I need to know who I am in the spirit. I need to know what you've called me to be. Come on, tell him what you want in your life. Come on, come on. Don't just be standing up here. Tell him what you want in your life. Tell him who you are in your life. Tell him what you'll be. Tell tell him what he's called you to do. Come on, tell him what the purpose is. Tell him where I will be and what God will do for me in my life. Come on, begin to say your name. Come on, begin to say your name. I will not be afraid. I will not be afraid of the arrow by night. Come on, or the arrows by day. Come on, I know who I am, and I know who God has called me to be. I know who I am, and I am not afraid. I am not afraid. I am not afraid. I bind anxiety. I am not afraid. I can do this. I can overcome this. I am not afraid. I am not afraid. I am not afraid. I am not afraid. You cannot be afraid of where God is taking you. You cannot be afraid of what God is doing in your life. I am not afraid. I am not afraid. I trust you even when I don't see you. I trust you even when I don't know what's going on. I'm not afraid. I am not afraid. Come on, open your mouth. Come on, I'm not afraid. Come on, fear not, for I am with you. Come on, fear not, for I am with you. Come on, fear not, for I am with you. Come on, fear not, for I am with you. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid, sister. Don't be afraid, sister. Don't be afraid, sister. God is going to do what he said that he's going to do. I am not afraid. 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 Anxiety don't got me. Anxiety does not have 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 me. I am not afraid. I am confident. I am confident. I know that you're going to do what you say that you're going to do. I am not afraid. I am not afraid. I am not afraid. I trust you. I trust you that every curse will be broken in my life. I trust you that every curse will be broken in my life. I am not afraid. 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 Come on, I am not fearful. I am not worried. I am not afraid. I trust you. I trust you. I trust you. I trust you, Lord. I will stop talking myself out of this. I will stop talking myself out of this. I know that I can do 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 this. I know what I'm called to do. I know God is going to do what he said that he's going to do. I am not afraid. I am confident. I am confident. I am confident. I am confident. I am confident that God has me, that God is covering me, that God is keeping me. I know I can do this. 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 I speak over your life. You can, and you will, and you must, and you shall, and you shall. You shall do what I've called you to do. Come on, I cover you. 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 Come on, this is your moment. No one else's. This is your moment. No one else's. This is your moment. No one else's. Come on, you're gonna do better this year. You're gonna do better this year. You will not make the same mistakes that you made the year prior to. You will not make the same mistakes that you made the year prior to. I can do this. 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 I speak that you are victorious. 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 You can do it. You can do it. I cover you. I cover you. I cover you. I cover you. I cover you, that you will think for yourself. I cover you, that you will not try to fit in. I cover you that you will be what God has called you to be. Nothing else but what he's called you to be. I cover you. I cover you. I cover you. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Come on, I cover you. I cover your necks. 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 I cover you. 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 Come on. Come on. You are covered. You are covered. You are covered. You got this. Come on, you got this. I speak strength over you. I speak life over you. Come on. Come on. I cover you. I cover you. Come on, you got it. Come on. I cover you. I cover you. I cover you. Come on, y'all, pray for these people. Come on, we cover you. We cover you. That God has you. Come on, stop worrying about what you cannot fix. I cover you. I cover you. Come on, we cover you. We cover you. Come on, we cover you. You're covered. Assignment while you're here. There's a moment when I can tell that my sons need me. There are certain cries that don't make me move. But there's this one cry that they make, it makes me move. Because it lets me know that they're in trouble. Your last assignment at this altar is to let out a cry to God to let him know that this ain't a pretend cry, but this is a cry that I need you. And I need you right now. So today I want you to lift your hands. I'm trying to teach you how to do it. I'm going to count to three, and I want you to let out a shout, not to me, not because I told you to do it, but I want you to let out a shout to God. And this is a shout that I'm ready to be rescued. This is a shout that I'm done with this. This is the shout that I am no longer going back. This is the shout that I got to do better than what I've done before. This shout ain't for my neighbor. It ain't for my friend. I'm going to count down to one, three. I speak that after you shout, you won't be depressed. I speak that after you shout, that anxiety will fall off of you. I speak that after you shout that you will stand and trust God like you've never trusted him before. Two, I declare that you are going to overcome every battle and every obstacle that has been standing in your way. Everything that has been told you that you were not good enough, that you couldn't make it, that you couldn't stand, that you couldn't do anything that God has called you to do. Come on, three, open your mouth. Come on, open your mouth. Come on, open your mouth. Come on. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. Come on, men cry too. Come on, men cry too. Come on, men get tired too. Men get weary too. Men get tired too. I'm not doing this anymore. I'm not doing this no more. I'm not going back no more. I'm ready for better. I'm ready for better. Come on. That's it. That's it. Shete, sonda na mosaya, sikonda na mose, Come on, 50 seconds. 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 Come on, men cry too. Come on, men cry too. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, out of your belly. 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 Come on, all this pain has to go. All this disappointment has to go. All this pain has to go. Come on. Some of y'all in the pew, you need to be on the floor. Some of y'all in the pew, you under the Mosiah. You need to be on the floor. Come on. Come on, I got 50 seconds. Come on, get what you came for. Come on, I got 50 seconds. Get that stuff off of you. Come on, get that depression off of you. Get that devil out of your marriage. Get that devil out of your house. Get that devil out of your mind. Get that devil off your back. Come on! Get it off you. Get it off you. Get it off you. Get it off you. I came weak, but I'm leaving here strong. I came here burdened, but I'm leaving here with power. Get it off you. Get it off you. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Get it off you. Get that thing off you. Get that thing off you. Get depression off of you. Get sickness off of you. Get anxiety off of you. Get pain off of you. Come on, I got 40 seconds. 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 Come on, get it off you. Come on, get it off you. Y'all get behind him. Come on, get it off. Come on, get it off. Get it off. Come on, get it off. Come on, get it off. Come on, get it off. Soto, Sunday to the Osiah. Soto to the Mahose. Sikanda to the Mosiah. Sunday to the Mahosiah. Sunday to the Osiah. Come on. Get it out. Sunday to the Mose. Sikanda to the Mosiah. Sunday to the Osiah. Some of y'all still ain't got out of your seat yet. Some of y'all still ain't got out of your seat yet. This next quarter is about to blow your mind. Come on, 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 come on. I brought you here for a reason. I brought you here for a reason. I brought you here on purpose. Brought you here on purpose. You came here with nothing, but I brought you here to change your life. I brought you here to transform you. Come on, get it off. Come on, get it off. Come on, yeah, that's it, that's it, that's it, that's it. Get it off. Come on, lift your hands, get it off. Come on, lift your hands, get it off. Come on, get that pressure off of you. You are not gonna die. You are not gonna quit. Get that pressure off of you, brother. Come on, you got this, man. Come on, you got this, 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 you got this. Come on, come on, come on, come on. I speak to that pressure. 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 I speak. Come on, everybody in the building. Come on, let out a cry to the Lord. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Come on, something happening in here.
Come on, let out a cry to the Lord. Come on, I can't let you leave here. Come on. Come on. The devil tried to set you up, but God about to take you through and bring you out. Woo! The devil is a liar. You got the victory. The devil is a liar. You've already overcome. You overcame by stepping down here. You overcame by making this step. You overcame by opening your mouth. You overcame by lifting in your hands. Come on, I need you to open your mouth if you're at this altar and give God a shout. Hey. About y'all, but I'm done losing. I don't know about y'all, I'm done being number two. I don't know about y'all, but I'm done being behind. So I got to give him a praise, because I'm done with being left out. I'm done with being looked over. I'm done with being behind. Come on. So I got to open my mouth and give him.
Running y'all ragged. We done with that today. We're done with that today. Because see, when you get tired, you say, I'm done. I ain't giving the enemy nothing else. I can't do nothing else. I am done. And today stops. It stops here. Thank you, Jesus. Hands lifted one more time. One more time. One more time, one more time, one more time. Come on, throw your name out. Jeremy Till. As you keep throwing your name, God is allowing people to pick your name up that don't even know you, that haven't even seen you. Your life is about to be changed. Hands lifted all over the building. As your hands are lifted all over the building. Declare that we are walking into a new season, that we are walking into a new time. We are not afraid, but we ready to conquer the giant, ready to step in front of, ready to move, ready to jump out and do what you've called us to do. We thank you. God, we thank you. And God, we honor you. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, clap your hands. Come on, clap your hands and give God praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We got
got one more assignment and I'm gonna dismiss you from this building. Well, I got two more and I'm gonna dismiss you out of this building. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all can go ahead and stand. They quick assignments, I promise. First of all, can we celebrate God for meeting us today? Assignment number one, if you don't have a church home and you want to make Living Faith your home, I want to open the doors of the church to you. If you don't have a church home online, somebody's there to open the doors for you. But if you're in this building and you don't have a church home, I want to open the doors of the church to you. You say, I don't have a church home, and I want to be a part of that church. I want to open the doors of the church to you. As we're waiting for that, I believe that when God gives you a word, that you should always sow into that word. So everyone in this room that can, I want you to get a seed of $33 in your hand or somewhere close to that. Can we put the giving information on the screen? I want you to get a seed of $33 or somewhere close to that. You don't have the 33, that's fine. We're not jumping hoops. We're not doing hocus pocus. We just want you to get that seed of $33 in your hand and stand. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Get that seed of $33 in your hand. Every person that's sowing, if you hold that seed up, come on, hold it up, hold it up, hold it up. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, today I ask that you cover every person that is sowing into this word. God, we declare that you'll cover us, that you'll keep us, and we declare that this word, God, will come back not void, but it will come back manifested in our life. And Lord, today I pray that you will help us be what you called us to be. And God, we praise you for your goodness, and we praise you for your mercy. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. If you're sowing monetarily, you may do so. And if you're sowing digitally, amen, just wave your digital devices to the Lord. If you are sowing digitally, if you'll just wave your device to the Lord. If you love your church, won't you give God praise? Standing all over the house. Everybody's standing. Everybody's standing. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your kindness and your goodness. And God, we thank you that you are a consistent God. God, as we go to our several homes, I pray that you keep us, cover our minds, cover our children, cover who you've called us to be. And Lord, I ask that you continue to touch our country with all the gun violence. And God, that you will have these young people put down these guns and learn conflict resolution. And God, not only will you do that, but that you'll cover us, that you'll cover our children, that you'll keep us, that you'll cover our minds. God, we thank you, and we honor you in Jesus' name. And all of God's people said, amen. God bless you. You are dismissed.
Pastor Tuck, I want to take a moment and thank all of our virtual viewers for taking out the time to join us in service today. Listen, the word today was absolutely life-changing, and I pray that it was life-changing for you. I pray that the word that you heard today has pushed you into your next, has challenged you to want to do more. I want to thank you for watching and for viewing and for tapping in with us on this afternoon. Listen, as you know, Living Faith is always doing stuff in the community. And if you ever want to sow, or if you ever want to jump in and be a part of this great ministry, you can join us by going to our website at lftchurch.com, or you can join us on any social media handles at Living Faith Tabernacle. Listen, I want to thank you for coming and joining us and being in service today. I'll see you on next Sunday at 10 a.m. Why? Because we are the church that makes you fall in love with church all over again. I'll see you next week.